Finally, 5 days later, the test results came in.
We found out that she too had cancer of the thyroid.
I thought, gosh, hasn't our family been through it enough already? So, yeah, I was pretty devastated to have to put our family through this again.
Becky had to have a second surgery to remove the rest of her thyroid. Then she was sent to Valley Hospital for a specific treatment developed to treat thyroid cancer. It's called iodine-131 therapy.
Since we come in, we're getting a few pills of radioactive iodine to treat thyroid cancer and moves the thyroid tissue around and kills itself. This makes her slightly radioactive to the point where she can set up airport alarms, things like that.
They put you in a hot room. And there's only a few hot rooms in town because the room actually becomes a little radioactive. And for about 3 days, the only person you see is the person with the Geiger counter.
As long as the radiation measured by the Geiger counter remained high, Becky's family wouldn't visit. She was completely alone.
Sometimes I worry, but most of the time I don't worry about my mom. It makes me feel like I'm kind of scared because they might not, like, get the cancer out or something.
3 days later, Becky's radioactivity was low enough she could go home. But still, she had to avoid touching her own children. For 2 weeks, small amounts of radioactivity continued to flush out her sweat and saliva.
It hurt. It really did hurt. And it was actually a little bit easier to be in the hospital because they could understand mom's in the hospital and can't go see her. It was a little harder. Mommy's home, but you know, she's not safe for us to sit on her lap. When you're going through all this and your emotion is to hold them the tightest, that's when you know, can't.
Ready, go!
It's been less than a year since Becky was diagnosed with thyroid cancer. Much too soon to be considered cured, but for now, Becky is cancer-free. Becky immediately turned her attention to how she could help others with cancer. Like Chris Millard, she too joined Lance Armstrong on the Tour of Hope.
Having had cancer and beating it does give you a sense of purpose sort of bigger than yourself. You know, Lance Armstrong is huge because he's Lance Armstrong, but Lance Armstrong, the cancer survivor, is that much bigger.
We welcome you to the 2005 Bristol Myers Squibb Tour of Hope.
She actually signed up for the Tour of Hope after the Tour of Hope passed out the strip in Vegas and now she's part of the team. Thank you, Lance.
I'm excited that she's getting the Tour of Hope and it's important for kids to like it here that have cancer.
You know, leukemia was a death sentence 40 years ago. And now it's like an 85% survival rate because kids signed up for clinical trials.
So ladies and gentlemen, Lance Armstrong and the Tour of Hope team.
I would feel remiss if I didn't participate in all the cancer awareness. I'm so lucky that Kelsey and I both survived our cancer. There's no way that I could turn my back on it.
As more of us survive cancer, more of us are going back to normal lives. In Lance Armstrong's case, that includes fatherhood, divorce, and a woman, Cheryl Crow.
So you've got 720 girls?
Yeah.
And a boy?
Yeah, what time is that?